Welcome back, students. Now we will discuss some topics of magnetic statics. We know that electrostatics and magnetostatics are two important branches of physics. In magnetostatics, we are dealing with the static magnetic field. So if a charged particle having charge Q is experiencing or is entering in a magnetic field, it will experience a force, and that force is given by F is equal to Q into V cross B. If the charged particle is subjected to both electric and magnetic field, the net force experiencing on the particle is known as Lorentz force, and that force is QE plus V into V cross B. This is due to the electric field and this is due to the magnetic field. If a charged particle is entering a magnetic field or it is moves perpendicular to the magnetic field, it will describe a circle. The radius of that circle is R is equal to MV divided by QV. We know that the most important law of electrostatic is Coulomb's law. Similarly, the most important law of magnetostatic is Biot-Savart law. Okay, so the magnetic field produced due to a current carrying element is given by this Biot-Savart law, and that is dB is equal to mu 0 into Idl cross R divided by 4 pi R cube. And if a straight current carrying conductor is there and we have to find out the magnetic field at the point P, so its value will be like this. All these are familiar for you because you already completed all these things. You already completed in your plus mu 0 I divided by 4 pi d into sine alpha plus sine beta. So next is the magnetic field strength at a point due to a long current carrying conductor is this one, B is equal to mu 0 I divided by 2 pi d. And if instead of a long current carrying conductor, if we have a circular loop, the magnetic field will be mu 0 I divided by 2 r, where r is the radius of that loop. And in the case of a solenoid, this becomes B is equal to N into mu 0 I, where N is the number of turns of the solenoid. And we know, you should remember that the magnetic field outside the solenoid is always zero. And so this is the axial points of the solenoid, F and E, and they are the end points there. The field will be B is equal to mu 0 N I by 2. So next is the case of a toroid. So the magnetic flux, the magnetic field due to that toroid will be B is equal to mu 0 N I divided by 2 pi r. So the magnetic force between two long parallel current carrying conductors, the force experiencing between them is this one, dF by dL is equal to mu 0 I1 I2 divided by 2 pi d. So the force is attractive if the conductors are carrying the current in the same direction, and force will be repulsive if they carry the current in opposite direction. The next is the magnetic field due to moving charges at any point P at a distance r from this charge. That is, the charges are moving. So the magnetic field expression will be B is equal to mu 0 into Q into V cross R divided by 4 pi R cube. And the magnetic force between moving charges, that will be mu 0 into Q1 Q2 into V1 V2 divided by 4 pi R square. So now we will discuss some problems based on this concept. A charged particle of mass m and charge q travels on a circular path of radius r that is perpendicular to the magnetic field B. The time taken to complete this one revolution is. So, since the particle is placed in existing in a magnetic field, it is undergoing a circular motion. So the expression is mv squared by r is equal to the force experiencing by the charged particle which is present in the magnetic field is qvb, the Lorentz force. So we are getting that mv by r is equal to qb, where v is velocity, that is equal to distance by time. Distance by time. So from that we can find out the time. So the distance traveled by the particle to complete one revolution, and also the particle is moving in a circular path. So it is moving in a circular path. So for one revolution, it is traveling a distance of 2 pi r. So velocity is equal to 2 pi r divided by time t. So we are substituting this 2 pi r by t instead of this v. So our expression becomes m into 2 pi r divided by t into this r is equal to qb. So this r get cancelled. And we require the time taken by the particle. So t is equal to m 2 pi divided by qb. So 2 pi m divided by qb. So the answer is option C. Next question. A circular loop of wire 4 cm in radius carries a current of 80 ampere. Current carries is 80 ampere. I is equal to 80 ampere. Find the energy density at the center of the loop. The magnetic field at the center of the circular loop is magnetic field at the center of circular loop is B is equal to mu 0 I divided by 2R. B is equal to mu 0 I divided by 2R. We need the energy density. So energy density U is equal to half B square by mu 0. Half B square by mu 0. Therefore B square is the square. Therefore energy density U becomes 1 by 2 mu 0 into mu 0 I square, mu 0 square I square divided by 4 R square. So mu 0, this one will cancel. We will get 4 pi into 10 raised to into I square 80 square divided by 4 into 16 into 10 raised to minus 2, converting to meter square. So we will get, on solving this, we will get 0.2 pi joule per meter cube. So the answer is option D. So next question. A proton moves with a speed of 5 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second along x axis. So velocity v of the proton is 5 into 10 raised to 6 meter per second. It enters a region where there is a magnetic field of magnitude B is equal to 2 Tesla. Directed at an angle 30 degree to the x-axis and lying in the xy plane, the magnitude of magnetic force on the proton. So when a proton enters in a magnetic field, it will experience the Lorentz force, and that force F is equal to Q into V cross V. So here we are taking only the direction, not taking the direction, only the magnitude. So this becomes QVB sine theta. So the charge of the proton is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 9. So F is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Velocity is 5 into 10 raised to 6. And magnetic field is 2 Tesla into sine 30. Into sine 30. The value of sine 30 is 1 by 2. On solving this, we will get 8 into 10 raised to minus 13 Newton. That is the force. So the answer is option C. Next question. If the cyclotron oscillator has a frequency of 16 megahertz, then what should be the operating magnetic field for accelerating the proton of mass 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27 kilogram? So for doing this problem, we should know the time period of a charged particle which enters in a magnetic field. So the time period of the charged particle which enters in a magnetic field is 2 pi m divided by qb. 2 pi m divided by qb. So if this is the time period, then frequency will be 1 by t. So f will be equal to qb divided by 2 pi m. And it is given that f is given, we have to find out b. Therefore, b is equal to f into 2 pi m divided by q. So f is given 16 into 10 raised to 6 into 2 pi into m, mass of the proton 1.67 into 10 raised to minus 27 divided by charge 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 90. And solving this, we will get 0.334 pi. So the correct answer is option A. These are some of the questions that are frequently asked. Practice more problems.